me, why don't you cook us up a big mess of chicken and dumplings, Shaq? That'd be hoobargood.
Hey boys, hey girls. I don't know what camera boy we're talking about over there. That would be pretty good, and I got some chicken. We'll get started on that. Miss JP got a different recipe for this. I like mine better. Now her late uncle had a recipe that was real fine, and it was so simple. It was simple, simple, stupid, and real good. But I'm gonna make it my way, because he ain't passed the recipe on to me. Alright? Good. Let me get prep. Let me get my pot out the damn cabinet and my chicken. So I got some fresh plucked chicken breasts. Yeah, I pluck all the feathers off of them. So I got some fresh killed chicken, and I plucked the feathers off of them while they was alive, and then I kill them, and I put them in this package right here. See, it say no salt, no artificial crapola. So 99 cents a pound, and this is 4.705 pounds. You say that right there. Look, I ain't lying. Let's make a stock with this. And the reason I chose this dish is because a couple of these are still partially frozen. We're going to thaw them out by making a stock. Trust me. So let's 100% natural. Okay. Well, I wanted organic chicken. I wonder what organic chicken is. Imagine that. So let's give them a... Let's not wrench them. Let's soak them. If I wrench them, that water gonna splatter everywhere. We're gonna put some cold water in here and soak them, and then pour that water out without making a splatter mess, getting salmonella or whatever all over the place, contaminating the whole kitchen. Because then you have to get the biohazard squad in here to clean up. The nuclear biohazard squad. We ain't got time for all that shit today. So, get your... After you touch the outside of the package, rinse your fingers off and put them chicken breasts down in there. Come on out of there. I know you're half frozen. You smell half frozen. See that? Put them in there. Now carefully discard this. It's a biohazard. All right. Wrench them under the water. Massage the breasts. See, that's what I'm doing. Hey there, breasts. You ain't squawking no more. Is that because of the breast massage? Oh, and I give free mammograms to all ladies. I just want to let y'all know that. Free. And I'm board certified too. Oh, hell yeah. Now let's dump this water out of there. Put some fresh water in. Rinse your hands with some hot water, JB. Sip a pop. Carefully pour this out. Trust me, it's pouring out and it ain't splashing everywhere. Let me show y'all something. Ooh, hot water. cool down a little bit. See, when you put your hand in there like that, see that water splattering everywhere? That's what would happen if you tried to wrench them in here like that. See the water splattering everywhere. It's all right, the hot water killed whatever was on my hand. We're still gonna scrub the sink down anyway, just a general principle. All right, put some hot water in there. Get you a Cajun mirepoix, however you say that word. Over this way, camera boy. Just rub it. And the greens on celery got more flavor, celery flavor than other stuff. Don't put the onion peelings in there. Just put some of that shit in there like that. And we're gonna cook this, make a little stock. Come over here. We're gonna put some more Cajun. We're gonna put a little Cajun season in there to give this a kick start. And there's your chicken stock. Now you don't gotta go buy none. I had to burp and cough while I was talking. Sip of Papa help. All right, so this is the start of your chicken and dumplings. You better be recording, you non-union cammy. So go and wash your hands. Especially the one you had down in the chicken. Use soap too. I've got soap on them. See the soap suds? Did you think I made a soap stone or some shit like that? Who knows what soap stone is used for? In construction. So burl that down for a little while, and it's gonna make a wonderful flavored stock. I also want to put some plain black pepper in there, but not too much, because what I got is real strong because it's fresh cracked. You could put whole peppercorns in here, but then you have to strain this, and we can most likely use everything that's in there without straining it. Later, after them chickens is cooked, we'll remove the skin, and those got bones in it, and that's what you want to use. Something with bones. Like thighs, legs, breasts. Wings don't have too much meat on them, so. But you can use them if you got them. Smoke them if you got them, boy. How about that? MJB, don't forget the garlic. Look, I got three little finger-sized toes. Put them in there. Bring that to a boil and reduce it to a simmer. Could you see down there? There's a mess over there. Miss JB and the daughter, they all getting ready for the wedding and Christmas. So the house is open. Stuff everywhere, except in my kitchen. I control this area somewhat. Boy, girl. So, yeah, you cover your pot in a boil faster because it keeps the heat down inside of it. But with something like this in here, you better stand right here till it starts boiling. Otherwise, it's gonna burl over on your stove. So, what did Buford say? Don't go to eat, don't go home, and don't play with yourself out here on the highway. On my highway, I'm sorry. It wouldn't look good on my highway, something like that, I don't remember. Smokey and the Bandit, all right. Stay here and watch the pot, and don't go home. Don't go to eat, and don't play with yourself. It wouldn't look good out here on my highway.
Now, got it.
All right. Now, let's go on and get out our chicken breasts. Look like they're swollen up. Man, wouldn't it be good if your wife's breasts would swell up like that? On their own. And see, there's a lot of grease in there from that skin. We're gonna take these breasts out. And keep them warm in the oven. And they're most likely cooked almost all the way. We'll put the oven on about to keep warm and cook a little more. And reduce this stock that they made. So I'm gonna put these fat side up, or skin side up. Yeah, that's the ticket. Can you see over here, boy? In the oven, and we're gonna reduce this. And let it get more effervescence or some shit like that. Now, burl. See, that's the beauty of gas. Look, watch, burl. Stop burling. Just like that. Burl. Electric cooktop won't do that, huh? We're gonna reduce this down some. By a good bit, because we got a skin, we're gonna get the skin off them chickens and remove the meat from the bones. All right? And women, don't try to do that to your husband. He wouldn't be happy with you. Alrighty, so we gotta get us some this chicken out of here. And see how him looks? Put them right there, like that. Our stock's done cooked down. It done reduced by 2/3. See, like that? Now, what we got right here, listen.
Ooh, cat.
Is Miss JB hollering in the background. Crispy chicken skin. Don't throw that away. Get that chicken skin off of that.
That's not the source.
Over here. And then we're going to debone this chicken and put that up in that stock. Oh, we got to strain some of that out of there. According to Miss JB. We'll see. So, let's get some of this. Yum. Fried chicken. Baked chicken skin. Yum. So let's deal with the rest of this. So get you some kind of straining device and get all of the washed up vegetables out. While our chicken's cooling, where you can handle it. The rest of them will be fine in there. Whatever left. Right? And try to stop eating all that good chicken skin. Bad hand. Yum. as your chicken cools down, go ahead and remove, you know, the chunks and the bones and stuff from it. Now keep in mind, using chicken breasts, they're stringy. See like that? But they're all cooked. And it's gonna make up a stringy-er chicken and dumplings, but who cares? Chicken breasts, we need some more flavor in that stock. And you can put Cajun seasoning. You really need some salt, number one. Then we gotta make some homemade dumplings from scratch. Miss JB's over there snickering at me.
Not snickering, just saying don't make
it
Cajun flavor.
Okay, don't make them Cajun flavored. Yum. We have fried chicken everywhere down here.
That baked chicken?
It's better. Oh, yeah. Man. I'm gonna get another pop. So now let's go ahead and dump us a little bit of fresh Trinity in here. About a cup. And let that cook. As you noticed, I put a couple carrots back in there from that stock. We're gonna put the chicken back in there as soon as this comes back up to heat.
Cat, you gonna have to move.
And cat gotta move. Cat over there on Miss JB's chair. Get off of that, cat. Play on the computer. Look, she right there. The JB computer right there. Cat hater. All right, we got our stock all cooking down like that there. I got a little bit of flour and water, cold water. And we're gonna pour that in here and let this thicken up a little bit. Now we gotta go make some dumplings. We're also going to put this chicken in there that I done deboned and ate the skin off of, at least most of it. Hope there's some more. Get that off of that, JB. Eat that skin off too. Yum! We may have to add some more liquid in here. Pretty sure we will. So we just do that now. Add some more stock, you don't have to. That's a concentrated stock. And I'm concentrating. Yeah, on drinking beer. Right. How about that? So now let's go ahead and make us some dumplings. Get you some on-purpose flour. That's all I got left. So we go ahead and put some self-rising flour in here too. We'll put all of that in there. Now what we want to do is coat all these flour grains down with some oil and some liquid. Hydrate them, in other words. And that's what's going to... We gotta put some seasoning in there. So you use salt and pepper. Use whatever you want. I'm gonna put some of that. I'm gonna put some more salt in there too. Hold up, let me go get the damn thing.
Well, that's what she was gonna do.
We want these to be nice and tasty. So you would hydrate them. Don't put egg in here. Don't do it.
But that is a good way.
Once you got your dry shit mixed all about like that there, now we're going to
wet these little grains of flour down and I'm making a dough. We're making it like a pizza dough, the same thing. The all and poof and liquid. You could use water. You use milk, it'd be better. Milk's not gonna work well for a pizza dough. I guess it could if it's powdered milk. Baker's powdered milk. That's the worry. That works well in a pizza dough. But that ain't what this is. We're not gonna bake this at a high temperature. We are going to take a little bit of this and sacrifice it. So we can roll it out and make dumplings. Hence, chicken and dumplings. So, adding some Earl. 1, 2, 3, 4 tablespoons. I don't know. Get a clean hand, JB, and put some milk in there. Who in the hell bought this low-fat reduced milk? I'm gonna go slap the piss out of them. Alright, now work all this in there. Let's make us a little dough. You can do this in your own home kitchen, just like I'm doing right here. If it needs more liquid, add some more liquid, boy. Come on, man. Girl, what's wrong with y'all? See, look, it's too clumpy. Need more liquid, so add some more milk. Mix, stir. Like little dog turds up in there, don't you? Be all right. More liquid. Will it clump? Oh yeah, look, it's clumping. So we close, we real close. See there? Little bit more liquid, not too much, JB. Don't mess up. And you had to go open another bag of flour. Down there, boy, down there. Oh yeah, we good now. So now we make some dumplings out of this.
Okay, I'll just grab it.
Oh. Uh-oh, no we can't. We have to open the other bag of flour, see it's too sticky. Bad, bad dough. Evil dough. Look at Frosty the dough hand. Alright, work all this stuff in there. Over this way. I gotta do it with my foot. I don't know why this ain't working for me. Come off of there. Get it on flow, get it every damn way. So work you out a dough like this. Tell it not to be non-union like this one's being. I may have over-wetted it. I don't know what the hell I've done. This is Miss JB's specialty. Tastes good. Like so, go on and cut you some dumplings out of this. You can make them in strips, you can make them in balls, you can, I don't care what you do. See, strips. Then slice strips. Come over there, boy.
What, honey?
Can you see over here?
No ice cream, buddy.
My head's so turning.
No, I'm not getting no ice cream, buddy.
No ice cream.
I'm sorry, honey.
Go put that on there. And you're going to have some dumplings. See? Or flavored biscuits, whatever you want to call them. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and put some of this dough in there.
We'll be all right.
With the flour, and that's gonna thicken this up even some more. We also got to get that chicken in there, which is in the oven, keeping warm. So let's do that. We got a sick grandkid over here. Miss JB telling me to please stop whining. No, I'm just joking. All right. Chicken. Go in the pot. Eat the leftovers. Put you some more dumplings in there. So what do you eat with this? You just eat it. It's like a soup with bread in it. It's chicken and dumplings. You want it with noodles, you want it with rice, do that. I really don't care.
Party to go to.
Regina told me, Miss JB told me, that I gotta put butter in here. Even though I got chicken fat. She said it gotta have butter. And milk too.
Milk?
Put milk in the dumplings.
Yeah. Oh, you didn't put milk in there?
No. Gotta put milk in there too. Damn it, boy.
Michelle.
Somebody gotta teach you how to cook.
Yeah, you got to scratch. I thought you were the cook in this family, dude.
Well.
Not the real cook.
Apparently not.
He's not the real cook.
I'm overwhelmed now. I got Miss JB and Miss JP. Miss JP's mama over there.
Yeah. And it's so sad that we're so shy and
unopinionated. That's right. We're just so shy and unopinionated.
How much milk I'm supposed to put in there? Milk? Okay. Miss JB gonna show me how to do this.
Maybe that's some water in dumplings.
Whoa, now, Aussie.
Probably more than that.
Okay. Milk.
You made dumplings, chicken soup with dumplings is all you made.
She telling me I'm being non-union is
exactly
basically what she doing.
Let me check it.
Lord.
Hey, Diana. You want some icing or sugar before you go home?
Well, Papa, she's been throwing up. Why would you want to give her sugar?
That's what we do with grandchildren. Send them home.
He's so silly sometimes.
You okay? You feeling better? Is JB fixing my dinner? Oh, it's looking better now.
She came and laid it in front of your feet.
Okay, we'll let it cook down a bit. I'll go get another beer. How about that? Woo! Was that in 3D? Woo! Am I in 3D? All right, boy. So, according to Miss JB, this is the way it's supposed to look. So we'll get some of this out of him. See right there? It could probably cook for about 5 hours in a slow cooker. But I'm hungry. So, I'm gonna get me some out of there. Eat some of this. Chicken and dumplings. We need rice? No. You need anything else? No. Just eat the saw, bitch. See right down there. I'm gonna say this now, and I'll most likely repeat it. What is the reason for the season? Oh, song pitch. Stand by. That was Miss JB checking on me, making sure I was. Oh, son of a bitch. So the reason for the season is not about, give me a present. Give you a present. That ain't what the reason is. This commercialism has gone too far. Think about it. What is the reason for Christmas? The true reason. If you really don't know, go watch Charlie Brown Christmas special. Linus will tell you, the little boy. So, I got me some chicken and dumplings right here. Get you a little more gravy, JB. That's the way it's supposed to be. Unless you make it with a dark, dark roux, but this is how it's supposed to be. Down there, boy, down there. Records when I tell you to, stupid. So I'm going back and watch The Polar Express. Excellent Christmas movie. Hope you enjoy it too. Well, go watch Charlie Brown.